Sometimes I hear Christians say, well, why should we get involved in politics? That doesn't do any spiritual good. And my response is, think about Ephesians 2, 8 to 10. The Bible says there, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that's not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. That's the heart of the gospel. Through trust in Jesus Christ alone, we gain salvation. But the next verse says this, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. He calls us to do good in this world. And one of the ways we can do good is by influencing laws and politics for good. I think doing that is a way of obeying Jesus' command, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. And it's a way of obeying the command, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. There are examples throughout history of Christians doing this, bringing influence to government. For instance, when Christians began to gain influence in the Roman Empire, they brought about the passage of laws that prohibited infanticide and child abandonment and abortion in the Roman Empire, 374 AD. Christian influence led to a law outlawing the burning of widows alive with their dead husbands in India in 1829. In the history of England, we find that William Wilberforce had an incredible influence on the British Empire. He campaigned and argued and debated for 40 years, but his efforts eventually led to the outlawing of the slave trade and then slavery itself in the entire British Empire in the early part of the 1800s. In the United States, the campaign against slavery was led by abolitionists, and about two-thirds of the leaders of those abolitionists were Christian clergymen who preached politics from the pulpit. They were preaching that slavery was wrong and the laws of the nation needed to be changed because these practices were contrary to God's moral standards in Scripture. More recently in our history, the Reverend Martin Luther King was a Baptist pastor who preached from the Bible that laws needed to be changed to outlaw racial segregation and discrimination in the United States. I think that was another example of a Christian pastor influencing government for good. So I encourage Christians in general and pastors in particular to continue that practice of influencing government for good according to the moral standards of God, which are wise and honorable and beneficial to mankind. And those standards are found in the Bible.